Y'all are now watching the Social Goats.
I'm recording, this is B-roll, so y'all might see this tonight.
We can tell where our cups came from. So these cups were made actually by Mother Hustler. Her son actually goes to the University of Texas. Football moms off the field, rivals on the field Saturday.
And our purses were also made by Mother Hustler.
Mother Hustler.
Yep.
Yes.
Can we find Mother Hustler on social media? I mean,
yes.
Who is Mother Hustler?
To her,
is that her actual name?
Yes. No, her name is Nivea Vaughn. But if you go to her Twitter, she is hilarious. So you guys have to go follow her. She makes all kinds of nice goodies.
Right.
These are rolling.
Yo, 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 yo. What up? SocialGoats Sports 365. I am very honored to be sitting in front of Miss Veronica Baker and Miss Neosha Brazel. Is it Brazel? Brazil?
Correct. Brazel.
Brazel. Mm-hmm. Okay, I didn't want to say that wrong. Take it out on me, man. We got y'all in a couple of weeks, Florida Gators. JG, lucky they don't got the Gators this year. But how are y'all doing today?
Good.
Okay. So, all right. Y'all already know, both of y'all sons have been on the Social Go show, and the fathers. So, you know, I believe that the beginning of everything starts with both of you. So, would y'all like to introduce yourselves to the people, and if people want to get in contact with y'all, how would they be able to reach y'all on social media?
Veronica Baker, I'm on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Neosha Brazel, and I'm also on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter.
Okay, so, like I said, we have the honor of interviewing y'all boys, and to my understanding, these boys have been knowing each other since how old?
I would say about, 7 or 8 maybe, or younger.
And this is grade school, Pee Wee football? I mean, what?
Pee Wee football.
Is this where they met? Okay, what positions were they playing at this time? Pee Wee football, y'all. We starting from the beginning.
I think Terrence actually played running back, if I'm not mistaken. Justin was quarterback, and he's playing some other positions, but mainly quarterback.
Okay. So, I'm not trying to offend the fathers, Cam, Terrence Marshall Sr., I'm not trying to offend y'all. Now, are the boys, would y'all consider them mama's boys, or father's boys, or both? I mean, what would y'all consider these boys?
Well, I'm just be honest, Justin, since he came home from the hospital, he's always been Papa's boy. So he's a granddad's baby. So he kind of just gets in when he fits in with mom and dad, but he's a Papa's boy. So he's his granddad's boy.
Okay.
Terrence is a mama's boy. Him and his dad, when it comes down to sports, they're like best friends, brothers, but anything else is mom.
Okay, so for our fans out here in Social Go world, Social Go Sports, what is something about these boys that nobody knows? You don't want to embarrass the boys. I mean, what's something, I mean, this mama, so I'm pretty sure they confide more in y'all than they do in their fathers. I feel, as a man, we feel more comfortable talking to our mothers. We tell our mothers everything. So maybe about experience with a young woman, or was there any situation that y'all can remember at the top of y'all minds that happened with y'all sons?
Well, I guess me and Justin, our relationship was kind of different. And it's not necessarily with girls or anything. I can just remember our conversations are always more
he'll tell some of his teammates now, my mama gonna tell me if I suck, she's gonna tell me if I'm good. Like, you know, he'll tell people now, man, my mama tell me you garbage. And, you know, a lot of people don't expect it necessarily because, you know, mama's the person that's gonna be like, oh, maybe it was okay. But, you know, I put just to the side like, dude, that was horrible. And so those are some of the things that people may not know, especially when you kind of think about it, when you have to think about, oh, so sometimes with me, I'm gonna tell just the good, bad, ugly, dude, that was horrible.
Straight up, whatever it is. Okay.
Yeah. Same with Terrence. We pretty much talk about, you know, any and everything. He doesn't hold anything back from me. Even when it comes to girls or a relationship he has been in, you know, he called for advice. You know, I remember one time he called me and I told him I was about to call his dad, and he said, if you call my dad, I'm not telling you nothing else. But he holds nothing back when it comes to me talking about, you know, school, God, girls, you know, anything. And I'm his encourager. You know, whether he's doing good or doing bad, I tell him, you know.
Okay, ladies, so we said Pop Warner football, we said maybe 5 years old, they both played quarterback and running back. Okay, so throughout this time, how did y'all two develop a bond?
Through football. It's funny because, like, it's been, you know, you get on the sideline, you're running up and down the sideline, cheering for your kids, and you kind of develop those bonds thinking you're a cheerleader, but then the fun, the bad, and the ugly, because what the public sees are all of the good things, but, you know, you don't necessarily see some of the other things that go on, you know, because we have lives, you know, we go through stuff, so it's some of the stuff that you may not necessarily see that goes on behind the scenes that you have to encourage each other through different times in life where, you know, your kids are going through things, your sons are going through things, and so you end up developing relationships with people that you may have not necessarily developed relationships with just football moms. No, you end up being a little more than football moms, because sometimes you're spending most of your time with these people. On the road, I mean, camps, this summer, well, not this summer, but the summer before they got injured, Justin and Moose together all summer. Going to camps on planes, so me and the others were together all summer. You know, so it's like you constantly seeing this person. So you end up developing a different kind of relationship. When Terrence and Moose got hurt, you know, it's like, well, who can I pick up the phone and talk to this guy? The same person was going through the same thing.
Right. What's your perspective?
Same. It's deeper than football. And I tell people all the time that, you know, they're on the outside looking in. You see the good. You see the glory. I can speak on Terrence behalf. You know, you see everything that's going on. Of course, you see his ranking. That don't mean nothing. You know, you see his status in high school. That didn't mean nothing. Because at the end of the day, Terrence went through a lot. And I know that nothing comes easy, and God has a plan for everything. And I'm just going to give you a little rundown of 4 years of Terrence High School. Going into his freshman year, the summer of May, he was playing basketball and fractured his fibula shin bone in his left leg. So he wasn't able to go in the summer workouts, you know, for his freshman. Going into his ninth grade year, you know, he lost his grandfather, which was my, going into his 10th grade year, he lost his grandfather, which was my dad, of August of 2015, and he was the first grandson. Going into his 11th grade year, he lost his grandmother, which was my mom, August of 2016. And then his senior year, he got injured the second game of the season. So he has been through a lot. And that's just the last 4 years, you know, of his life. You know, not saying that, we know that God don't make mistakes at all, period. That didn't get us down.
they're supportive of saying, you know, everything is meant to be. I mean, Terrence is so positive. You won't hear him complain about anything. I mean, if he asked to go to the hospital, then something, he got to be dying, you know. And even today as we speak, I mean, I can ask him something, and I can't be negative because of him. You know, I try to stay positive because of him, because he's such a positive kid. You know, he, anything negative, he don't want to hear.
So ladies, how are y'all adjusting to y'all baby boys being away from y'all?
At first, it was hard, I'm not gonna lie. When I took Terrence to school to drop him off, it was like I was reliving my parents' funeral all over again. Like I was going to get rid of him, but it was in a good way. And I cried, and I cried, and I cried because I'm used to him being home. You know, because me and his sister, we really took care of him. Like, his sister would be cooking. He would pace the floor, rushing her like she is wife or something. You know, he was just that baby because he really didn't have time to do a lot, from football to basketball to track. You know, so we made sure he was straight. We made sure everything was taken care of. So just him not being in the house, man, that was hard. But, you know, I'm good now because I know he's in good hands. LSU is taking great care of him. I mean, even his first time going to the grocery store since he been at LSU, you know, he's excited. He FaceTimed me. You know, I'm like, you growing up, because he have to do it now. But it was hard.
Ms. Baker?
Well, my transition wasn't that hard. Like, I thought I was gonna be emotional, but I think knowing that Justin chose a school that was so family-oriented, when we got there and dropping him off, I felt like I was leaving him at home. So it was like when we left him, he was basically like, y'all leave me, y'all ready to go? So it was, I was like, well, dang, you know? So I just felt like I was like taking him to a relative's house and dropping him off. So it made the transition from, you know, here to college a lot easier. Like, I thought I was gonna cry. We thought we were gonna be a nervous wreck, but actually we weren't, because I felt like I was just leaving him, you know, with family members or whatever. And then knowing Justin, like, Justin has always been really mature for his age. So it's like, you know, I knew he was gonna be good. I knew he was gonna be surrounded by great people. So it was never that fear of, oh my God, I'm losing my baby. So it was, I didn't have any anxiety. I didn't have any worries. You know, sometimes it's crazy because the school, you know, they send these mass messages and stuff out, you know, when they're sending you notifications on your phone and stuff, in which a lot of times they're just testing their systems. And I sent him a message, you know, like, they better quit playing with me because I'll hit 20 in a minute. And he like, with the mama, and yeah. But, you know, they're like just sending you messages and notifications, but it's like weird because it's like, my baby is gone at college. You know, I have to, you know, it's like, I didn't go through that because it was, I kind of just felt like I was just, like I said, leaving him. But I think that was more so because mine was, he wasn't really, he was so mature, I didn't feel like I was leaving my baby because he just always been so mature. So it was just like, okay, well, just because, you know, you did. But, you know, we had the grocery store calls, you know, Walmart don't ran out of noodles. I'm like, really, just noodles? Oh my God.
Okay, ladies, the question of the hour. Did y'all both believe that y'all children's relationship, y'all boys' relationship, did y'all believe they would go to school together?
I wanted them to go to school. I was fine after I spoke with Terrence about it, and he told me that him and Justin had to do what was best for them.
Okay.
You know, it's something that they would have loved to do also, but they did what was best for them.
So, do y'all believe that decisions were already made prior to signing day, and, you know, they both, did y'all both, were y'all surprised to hear them? Was it a surprise to y'all or no?
Yeah, Terrence told me where he was going. He signed on a Thursday, on a Friday at 12, I think. And he told me where he was going at Thursday at about 10:30. We had no idea where he was going. It was hard. It got hard at the end, but, you know, I just told him to put their phone down, don't answer for no coaches, and you need to go into prayer and seek God, you know, for your decision. I prayed, my pastor prayed, and actually God gave me a dream, and I wrote it down, and I sealed it up in the envelope without, you know, me knowing where he was going to go, and my dream was, it was actually true.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, my sister, she worked at LSU in the operating room, and which they changed the name to University Health. And I dreamed that we was giving my sister a big celebration party for her accomplishment and things she accomplished while she was at LSU. She ended up leaving and moved. My sister moved to Houston. She wasn't even working at LSU anymore. So I was like, why am I having a dream about my sister at University Health? You know, we having her this party. She's not even there anymore. And it hit me, and it was like, University Health used to be actually LSU.
Right.
So I wrote this dream, you know, on a piece of paper, and I sealed it up. And my cousin, I gave it to her, and she actually opened it after signing day. And it was LSU.
Wow. Baker?
I think Justin was a little different, and, you know, with quarterbacks, they tend to make their decisions a lot sooner than other players because quarterback spots are not as fast as open as the other players. I mean, they like to get their decisions out of the way. But Justin and I would always have conversations, basically, kind of like Yosha said, she can never tear. Basically, you have to go where you feel you need to go. And your decision can't be based on what society deems popular or any of that. And so, you know, Justin's decision, you know, was based on where he felt he had, you know, the best relationships with the coaches and where he felt was going to best suit his style of play, which is what your decisions get to be based off of. And he basically had a great relationship with the coaches at TCU. He knew that I love those coaches. You know, there's just some things as a mother that you can discern when you go to different places. And I had gone to TCU and met these coaches for the first time. And it was specifically the quarterback coach or the offensive coordinator, Tony Comby. And it was just something about this man. And I always felt like when you send your kid out to college, you want them to go somewhere. This is my son. This person is going to be growing my son into a man because his father's not going to be there, his mom's not going to be there. So I need him not to only be able to go and talk to this person about football, but I need to be able to go, him to go and talk to this person about life. So this was somebody I felt like this could go and talk to about life. So fast forward some years, not some years, but some months. And, you know, I had been going through some things in life. And Justin's coach calls to check on me. And it was because Justin had gone and had a conversation with him about his mom going through some things in life. And it just, like, it was a surreal moment because it's like, you can go sit down in your coach's office and have a conversation with him about not only your life, but your mama going through something.
Right.
You know, and for him to pick up the phone and call and say, are you okay? Like, it's more than just going out there and throwing a pass. It's more than just going out there and putting on some pads. Like, these kids have to go somewhere where the people actually care about them as individuals. Like, you see on TV so much today or in the newspapers where our kids are going to schools and they're committing robberies there. Not to say that it's the coach's responsibility to keep our kids out of these instances, but
there's a person that can talk to them or keep them rooted and grounded,
right,
when the parent is not there, right, or they have somebody they can feel comfortable going to talk to other than somebody that's using them for their athletic ability. I need my baby to be able to talk to somebody, like,
right,
you know, mama not there. I need him to go be able to sit down and talk to somebody.
Right.
So ladies, like I said, I don't want to hold y'all time anymore, but I want y'all to look at these mugs they have. I mean, you see an LSU Tiger on this mug, and you see a Horned Frog on this one. You know what I'm saying? I have my Gator stuff up here. I have my Gator's cup up here. I don't know why they didn't bring me a Gator cup, but I guess they really didn't know. Now, I was afraid to do this interview because they both say they're going to come with it. They're being nice. Prior to the interview, I asked them to be nice. Okay, so, you know, like I talked to dads, and I'm talking, SocialGoats would love to cover their growth and actually bring you and the fathers back. Do y'all think it's possible to have y'all with the fathers on the interview?
Possible. We can make it happen.
Okay. Well, like I said, before we go, y'all know what's going on in the NFL, and I know y'all probably have to have these talks, you know, about the anthem and stuff like that. I mean, not with showing, you know, any favoritism either way. Have y'all had to talk to y'all sons about that particular situation? You know, like, I guess that decision making. Because, you know, like with Colin Kaepernick, you know, he made a decision and it cost him, you know, what he's doing or whatever. Have y'all had conversations with y'all sons? As far as, I mean, not literally that. I'm just saying as far as the decision-making part of life.
Yes, we have. I've talked to Terrence about it.
Okay.
Yeah, I know Justin and I have, when I say keep a real conversation, keep a real conversation, just because that's society that we live in today, and I feel like as a mom, just have to have those keep it real conversations,
right,
and not just about the anthem. I mean, these are young boys, so we have to have conversations about everything. I mean, you know, domestic violence is here, and it's one of those things, dating violence. Sexual violence, you know, these are our young boys. These are popular topics nowadays. And
right.
So these are all conversations that you have to have with your sons, and then especially if they're athletes. So these are conversations that we have, and I just try to tell Justin that you have to make not just decisions for yourself, but you kind of have to make decisions based on what all of society, you know, needs you to make. So, you know, what you may think, oh, I'm just making this decision for Justin. Justin got to step back and say, I'm making this decision for half of America, because that's who could be with you under this big old microscope.
Ms. Brazel?
Me and Terry, we talked about it, but he's the type that is saying, when we get to it, we'll discuss it. It's not like I guess he feels more like now ain't the time, but it is the time, but on certain things. But even with little girls, I tell you, now ain't the time right now. I mean, you get that, you leave the girls alone, we don't need no babies, I'm not trying to be no grandma right now. You know, I just keep it real, you know, because with so much happening, like you say, with the athletes, with the violence and stuff like that, you know, you have something bigger in front of you right now. You know, all this other stuff can wait. You know, it's going to be a time when you can come and you can play and do all the other stuff later, you know, but at the end of the day, I mean, hey, if they ask you to stand up, stand up. If they ask you to sit down, sit down.
Right.
It's just, I mean, I'm not going to teach him, you know, to be disobedient to what, like you say, it's bigger than him.
Right.
It's bigger than not saying that you let these people run over you or you don't take a stand for what you believe. But like I say, at the end of the day, when that time comes, we don't have to cross that bridge, we'll cross it.
Okay.
But just do what you ask.
Okay. Hey, well, like I said, y'all, it was an honor and a pleasure to interview Miss Neosha Brazel, Ms. Veronica Baker. We're going to have them back. We plan on having Terrence and Justin back. And we're going to also have Terrence Sr. and Cameron Rogers back to chill with the Social Goats. And like I said, I really appreciate y'all for having this conversation with me. I plan on covering and continuing to actually follow the growth of your sons. And from what I've seen in meeting them, they stand out. You know, like, they don't seem like the type of boys that's going to follow the norm. They both seem like they're very stern to be who they are.
Right, right. They know who they are. And they know whose they are. That makes the difference. See, you know, because those boys have God, and they fear God. And, you know, and it makes a difference, you know, when you have God in your life, you know. And, like, Terrence already knows. So I'll tell him in a minute. He called me with some. You need to pray. You know, give it to God. You know, God will give you the answer. You know, serious. I ain't just saying this because we on TV and it sounds good. But, I'm dead serious. And he know. I mean, he don't mind, you know, putting a situation before God. You know, he's a dreamer. You know, God speak to him through dreams. You know, I have a dream, and I share it with him. And at 18, I tell him, you know, I don't understand. And he say, Mama, God is going to reveal to you. And just recently, I had a dream and told him the dream. Didn't know who it was about. Couldn't remember the faces. And the next day, and he a witness, he dreamed, and he called and told me, he said, I have to bring it to your dream. And he dreamed this, you know, and God showed it to him. And he told me exactly who the person was and everything.
Wow.
So, it's real.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, they have a great, great, great support system. Like, I tell this all the time, like, when he got injured, you know, that was a hard, they worked hard. Like all summer, that summer to get where they were, and it was just like you could have just took their lives from under them. Like, I mean, you can't even like wrap it into words, because I just remember sitting in those stands that Friday night, looking in my baby's face, and it was just like his whole. Just everything, just, and I'm like, what do I do? But then I know that I got to suck it up, because I got to go tell him to suck it up, because this is what, like, nothing in life happens without a reason. And so while you may not understand right now why your senior season has been washed away, there's a reason for all of this, and it's hard to conceptualize right now because, oh, this is going to be a long road, and there were times when, you know, Justin was in that room, and I had to say, so you just going to sit here and lounge around, or you going to suck it up, like, literally suck it up, like, it is not, and this is like 3 weeks post-surgery, suck it up, like, get up out this bed, suck it up, and, you know, he's looking at me like, really, what is she coming in here, like, what? But literally, like, this is not what you do. Like, this, get up, get yourself together. What you gonna do, lay in this bed? Or, you know, I had a conversation with Justin after a camp he went to in Dallas. And Justin performed so horribly at that camp. Like, I had never seen such. I wanted to take a football and out of the stand and throw and put a Justin in the sand.
Wow.
Like, it was just that horrible. And I had to have a conversation with him because I was like, if this is how you're going to perform in camp, like, we don't have to spend any more money to go to any camps, because this is the part of the real life story that people don't see. Like, sacrifices, spending money. And so I was like, what do you want to do in life? Like, what do you want to be? And he sat on that couch and he said he wanted to be a professional athlete. So when you sit on the couch and tell me you want to be a professional athlete, then that means that you're willing to take the sacrifices that come with it.
Right.
So when you step out on that field every Friday night, you know one of the things that come with that is the possibility to get injured. But that Friday night, you're injured. So you're going to lay in this bed, or you're going to get up and go do what professional athletes do in rehab. So he did what he had to do and got his
now he's in college and he's going through the stage where you interact with other players on your team that are going through injuries and stuff. And so I had to tell him, I said, now you understand the reason. You didn't understand it then, but this is your reason. You can now be able to tell other people what you think, but you can help other people do this. You can. So you didn't understand it then, but you can understand it now. A lot of times God takes you through things so that you can help other people do this.
Right.
So now get to help.
Alright, ladies, like I said, I appreciate y'all once again. Like I said, we're gonna see these ladies again, y'all. And next time I represent, I'm gonna have my cup. I'm gonna make sure it's outshining their cups when I come next time.
And we're gonna be on the sofa next time.
Yep, they're gonna be on the sofa. They coming to the cave.
Now, SocialGoats gonna have them a whole studio.
Yeah, we coming with you. You heard? Speaking into existence. Let's get it.
Right.
Thank y'all.
Oh,
SocialGoats.